Hi there folks, thanks for clicking onto my channel today. This is Cooking with Sasha China, and today I'm going to show you how I do homemade pasta with literally just two ingredients. So first off, I have been away. I haven't been able to upload a video for a long time, but we're going to kickstart off with two videos. So the first one is actually going to be homemade pasta with two ingredients, and then I'm going to cut that video, edit it, send it out, whatever. And then I'm gonna do the actual dinner I'm making, which is a homemade pasta dish with red deer sausages. Yes, red deer. And with a simple tomato sauce that we're gonna oven roast these bad boys, try and get a bit more flavor out of them. So the first thing you're gonna need, obviously for the pasta, is a big bag of flour. Doesn't really matter what flour you use. If you want gluten free, you can use that, or whole wheat, or semolina, or any kind of flour. I just got the this one own brand, because there you go. And you're also going to need some eggs as well. And then you're going to need a bowl to put the dough in when it's resting, with some cling film. And obviously you're going to need your whack-a-dack-a-doo-dee, your rolling pin. Alrighty guys, so let's start off with the homemade pasta. Let's get cooking. Yeah. Okay, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is obviously choose, hello, that's falling over. Is actually choose what surface you're gonna make the pasta dough on. You can either make it in a bowl, which is gonna be super less messy, or you can do it on a slab or a chopping board or whatever. But I've done it on my countertop. Obviously you gotta sanitize the heck out of it, as you do. So what I've done, I've put some flour on there, made a little well for the eggs. So obviously, like I said, it's two ingredients, which is flour, whoopsie, and eggs. So usually it'll be four large eggs, but since these are only the small ones, I'm gonna do five. So what we're gonna do, crack them and then pop them in there. Okay, so like I said, it is gonna be messy. So I've got my flour, I've got my eggs in there as well. One tip also to remember is try and get your eggs at room temperature, because it'll just make it a lot easier. Now this is the messy bit. Now that's not me farting, it is actually my floorboards. And now we're gonna just try and work it all together. Now obviously what you don't wanna do is add any more liquid, because obviously when it's in the resting period, that's when it's gonna really absorb all the moisture that's in there. So we're gonna try and like knead it. And yeah, you're gonna get flour going everywhere, and it probably looks pretty disgusting. So I'm gonna stop talking now, because when I actually do the video, I am going to fast forward this. Alrighty. Okay, so now I have finally managed to get it into a reasonable looking state. So now what we're gonna do is actually wrap it up. That's where our cling film comes in. Oh God, that was a workout. Hopefully I can fast forward it properly enough for you guys. So we're gonna wrap it up, put it in a bowl. Try and get it in, so it's gonna wrap the whole thing up for us. Nice and tight in there like that. Alrighty. Okay, so I've wrapped the dough in cling film, popped it in a bowl. I'm now gonna pop this into the fridge to rest for at least half an hour. So when I'm doing that, I'm now gonna start on my tomatoes.
Okay.
I dropped it. Okay, so now we're kind of moving on to the other part of my video, which is making the basic tomato sauce that is going to go with the homemade pasta. So obviously you want to get your tomatoes like that, obviously give them a quick rinse, and then obviously get whatever dishes you want. My oven is preheating, it is at gas mark 6. Obviously the first thing we're going to do is just place them into the dishes or ramekins, whatever you want to roast them in, because I think by oven roasting them you bring out a lovelier deeper flavor, whatever. So the first thing you're gonna do, you can cut these out if you really want to. Me personally, I'm not really fussed. I know that some people be like, oh yeah, cut it out. Me, yeah, you know. So I'm gonna give them a cross on each by doing that. So you just take a small chef's knife or a paring knife or whatever, throw that in there like that. Okay, so they're nicely organized. I'm gonna pop those to the side. I'm gonna get myself a couple of garlic cloves. I'm not even gonna bother to peel them, bash them that way. Hello. You know, you're just getting the flavor out of them. Just throw those in there like that. Throw the skins in as well. Sorry, didn't do that on camera. So I literally just pop them in, as you can see, just there. Throw them in just like that. What you're gonna wanna do now, bit of black pepper on them. Oh, Kevin decides the cause, I'm doing the video. Gosh. Right, pepper in there. I'm gonna have to call him back afterwards. I don't know if you guys can see that, if that's blocking your view. Pepper. Salt. Get those crumbs in the bin. And then what we're going to do now is pop in some olive oil. Just, I like to drizzle it actually inside. There's quite a lot actually going in there. Never mind. It's all part of the process. So, I do want to show you guys what I got the other day. Look at this Greek olive oil. Isn't that perfect? Greek extra virgin olive oil from Lidl. I don't know if I can say that, but I got that one. Then also my sister got me that for my birthday last year, which I only picked up early this year. Anyway, enough about that. So what I'm going to do now is, on a baking tray, pop these. I'm going to pop them into the oven and let them roast away, because we're going to use these for the, whoa, that's hot, hello. Start looking into the sun, put my head in there. All right, so guys, so that's the pasta, that's still resting. I put in about 3:20, so I'm gonna come back at about 4 o'clock-ish to take that out. I can easily just move the camera up instead of like crouching down like Hidden Dragon. Hello. So my tomato's in there roasting. I've done my pasta, which is resting. I'm now, time is it? 3:31. Going to have a glass of wine. I am working tomorrow, so I can only have the one. What can I do? Oh, I haven't really thought this through. I mean, all right, we'll be back. Okay, so the pasta is, or the pasta dough is still in the fridge resting, as it is 3:37. I put it in about 3:20. I then did the tomatoes that are currently roasting away, nice and lovely in there. And now I've got the frying pan ready. I know that some people go, oh, you shouldn't season the pan, you should season the meat, blah, 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 blah. I just did it in there. So I'm now gonna fry off the sausages that I've got, the red deer sausages. The place where I got these from was actually in, I didn't actually get them, one of my boyfriend's friends actually got them. But oh my lord, I need him. Fucking ate that. I'm so sorry. You didn't hear anything. Anyway, so we're gonna put these bad boys in here. Like this. They're kind of like pepperami kind of things. Gonna throw them in for now. And my hand is completely touched that. Give me 2 seconds, guys, 2 seconds, and I'm cut out. This bit, I'll have to Right, so that bit I'll have to turn that bad boy down. It's going a little bit crazy. So, probably just give these guys a bit of a trim. But I just want them really just to cook, and then we can start slicing them up and stuff. I know I could have done this before I put it in the pan. You know, normally I do, but for some reason, not really thinking today. That's it. So just cut them up into. So obviously, yeah, if you don't have asbestos fingers, don't do that. So pretty much just let them cook off now for a bit. We don't want them too overdone. Hold on, let me just come back to you guys. There we go. So let them cook off a little bit more. Once they're cooked down, we're going to take them off and then we're going to rest them up. So look at this. So I've literally just put in salt and pepper. That's it, please. It's smoking a little bit. I'm just going to add in a touch of water. There we go. Just going to deglaze the pan by doing that. But obviously you're going to lose the caramelization on the sausages a little bit. But the main thing is, it's going to be nice and done. So, we're going to let those cook down. And then once we've cooked it down, we're going to come back. Bye. Oh no. Hello. Okay, so what I've done now, I've added in a bit of garlic salt and also some parsley and fennel as well. So I'm thinking the fennel will go really nice with the gaminess of the red deer sausages. So what you want to do, these are quite small, so it's like 10 to 15 minutes. You've got to be like super careful with them and stuff. You can do it for 20 minutes, boom, but they're going to be like bouncy and overcooked. But, you know, totally up to you guys. I'm going to do mine for about 10 to 15 minutes as they are quite small. I have put the lid on just to try and keep in the dampness. Alright, so I'm just letting that cook away while everything else is sorting itself out. Okay, so the sausages have been cooking and they're now cooked. They've got a great caramelization on them. They're spitting at me. Right, so what we're gonna do is let these take them off the heat. And we're just gonna let them cool down. Oops, there. So, hallelujah, that's hot. So I don't know if you can see them, but that's them there. We're gonna let them cool. What I do want to do is actually keep the oil, because when we eventually come to cook the pasta in the pot, ow, that's hot as well. obviously you're gonna salt the water as well, but also some people add in some oil so the pasta doesn't stick together, but we're gonna actually use the oil from the sausages in the pasta water as well. Recycling and also flavor them. Right, so I'm gonna find something to put the oil in. Yeah, we'll come back when that's done. So the sausages are done. I'm gonna check on the tomatoes. Actually, I might as well do that now. Ooh la la, Lord have mercy, that is hot. Those to one side. Then cool, we don't want them to cool in the fat, because then what's gonna happen? They're gonna go all white and skinky. Okay, let's have a look at these tomatoes. They are looking fandabby-dozy, as you can see, and here, and it smells absolutely gorgeous. Alrighty. Okay guys, so my dough is ready. Da, 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 da. My dough is ready now, and now we're gonna make it into the pastas. So as you can see, hello, tiny bit there. It's really absorbed all the moisture because the flour absorbs it. That's basically what I'm just trying to say. So what we're going to do now is we're going to get some flour. We're going to put it on the countertop again. Really just not an awful lot. Put that to the side. Spread it out. Again, obviously make sure you've got clean hands and clean surface. We're going to chop it into quarters. So basically cut it into fours like that, and you can just work with whatever you got. So the others, so I'm gonna do one at a time. So what you're gonna wanna do is get some cling film, get the others, put it to the side. You're gonna wrap it in some cling film, like that again, and you're gonna put a clean tea towel over the top because you don't want the air to get to it. So just tuck it up, make sure it's nice and not aired, whatever. Okay, so now we're just gonna roll it out. Now this is gonna take a while, so what you're gonna wanna do is try and roll it as thin as possible. The aim of the game, thin as possible, because obviously once you start cooking the pasta, it's going to plump up and get a lot bigger. So the thinner, the better. So it is gonna take a while. It is gonna take some elbow grease because you don't have a pasta, what is it called? Except for just these guns. Bang, bang. Joking. All right, guys, so I'm gonna do that. It's gonna be a while, so I'll see you guys when it's done. Okay, so now that is pretty thin. Obviously, you want to make it as big as possible. This kind of looks like it's in a diamond shaped. But anyway, so what I'm going to do now is just roll it, because I'm going to make tagliatelle, because you can either do like ravioli and make a nice little... Sorry, I'm out of breath. Crikey, I need to go to the gym more. You can either make like tagliatelle or ravioli and stuff. So what you're gonna wanna do, roll it up like that. You're gonna wanna get it on your chopping board here. Let's see if you can see me actually if I do that. Da, 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 da. Without my camera falling down. Can you see me? You can just about see me. Let's see. There we go. Okay, don't mind the plants in the background. It was sunny, so I thought they deserve some light. So what you're gonna wanna do is just literally chop it like that, okay? So we're gonna wanna do real thin, all thick, however you want to do it. I should have really shown you, but then I'm gonna roll out all the other stuff there. So I don't want to. So, obviously, you need a nice sharp knife. If you haven't got a knife sharpener, I highly recommend getting one, because obviously in these ones, you can do the coarse or the fine. Really good. Really, really useful in the kitchen. Really. Because there's nothing worse than actually cooking in the kitchen and not having it nice and sharp. Okay, so I'm gonna quickly show you here. So that's what I've done. Again, not me farting, it's the floorboards. So as you can see here, look at that. So now what we're gonna do, I'm gonna place that back on there. We're gonna get our flour back on the... Oh, here we go. Can you see? Yeah, so we've got our flour. Just throw it out on the... Throw it out. You know what I mean. Just pop it out there. We're gonna get our pastas. And we're just going to throw it on there. And just let that hang loose. Hang loose. And literally, look at that. Here is your fresh homemade tagliatelle pasta. So just unravel it. What I'm gonna do now is literally just put it on to, well, put it in a dish just to air dry out a bit, and then I'm gonna cook it later. The tomatoes, however, I must say, I have turned the heat off, and they're just sitting in the oven in there just to get the final last bit of roastings. Just be a bit gentle with them. I was a bit heavy-handed with that one and snapped it. But yeah, there we go. So this is your fresh tagliatelle pasta. I will say now, I can tell that I haven't rolled it out as thin as it should have been, but you know, that's fine. So what I'm gonna do now is get my dish that I wanna put them in, and I'm just gonna put that to the side there, like that. Okay, so now I'm gonna crack on with the other three pieces that I have on the side. So obviously it's better the thinner you roll it out. I thought I'll quickly show you me rolling it out, and whew, it's a hot day here in the UK. And yeah, and I think my problem is I'm not as tall as one should be, so trying to get on top of it, literally, to roll it out is a bit hard. It's not as easy as a average height person would have. So I'm having to actually stand on my tippy toes, put a bit of pressure on the dough as I'm rolling it out. But as you can see, it just needs to be real thin. When you think it's thin enough, keep going, even thinner, because what you don't want is for it to be not as thin as you wanted, and when you cook it, it's gonna puff out and it's gonna be quite thick pasta like the other batch. So I'm just gonna keep rolling it out. Okay, all right. So I'm now currently on my third bit, and I don't know why the camera's like that, I'm giving up. Oh my life, my arms are literally giving out on me. I'm gonna make it thin, thin, thin. Yeah. A bit more flour there. Flour helps, because with it being on the bottom as well, it's helping it move around and stuff. But yeah, just keep working at it. Work, work, work. I wish it wasn't so damn hard to leave ya. Miami sucks, she's a la la la. It's true, la la la. Oh, I should be running. Oh, you keep me coming. Fire acting now or dead. There's just some things that never change. You say we're just friends, but friends don't know the way it tastes. La la la. Girl, you know it's been a long time coming, don't drag me far.
Siempre, pero el mundo va a llegar a tu casa, tienes que ir a hacerlo buscar. ¿Me entiendes, cariño? Tu abuela también le encanta las novelas de romance. Solo sacaste de mí. No te preocupes, Bella, déjalo lo que eras. Pero yo entiendo que si tú no quieres, te puedes quedar con tu abuela. Nos quedamos al frente del mueble y vemos nuestras películas de romance. ¿Qué tú piensas? ¿Te gusta?
I'm gonna go right now. Okay, you guys have fun though. Okay,
Bella, por I'm favor, ten cuidado y abrígate.
Ponte
un abrigo que te explique.
Okay, bye.
Esa muchacha, esa hermana tuya, salió. Vente, vamos a ver películas. Mi
amor,
mi nena tan rarita. Yo la amo. ¿Qué vamos a ver, mi niña?
Still recording.
Awkward.
Okay, so I'm finally finished. So this is my homemade fresh tagliatelle that has been a labor of love. So now I'm just letting it air dry a bit. So I'm just going to carry on with the rest of the video. I know I said that at first I was going to do two separate videos, but I think I'm just going to do it all as one because, you know, getting on a bit. So my tagliatelle is going to dry now. I'm just going to pop that up here. I'm now going to clean the surface and then get my tomatoes sauce going. Okay, so what I've done, I've got my cooled sausages. I've sliced them up. I've also got my, it's come out the oven, it's hot, my tomatoes that I've been roasting. They are gorgeous. I've got my tagliatelle that is air drying. I've also got a pot of hot water on the boil, and I've also the leftover oil from the sausages I have popped in the water there. So now what we're going to do with the tomatoes, we're going to get a saucepan, like so, put that in there. We're going to literally just get the whole tomatoes, try not to get the garlic peel in these ones now, and we're going to put these into saucepan, and then these have got the sweetness, because the only thing is from the right, so once we've done that, put everything in there, pause. Okay, so what I did, I actually got some of the garlic that was in here and just squeezed it on top, squeezed all the oils out of there. We want as much flavour in there as possible. Like I say, it's going to be a simple sauce. Take that away. Put that. That. And so, what we've got here now is our tomatoes. that. Ooh. If you can see here, we're going to just mash up into a nice liquid. So those middle bits there, they're going to be quite firm. You're going to see lots of seeds in here, but I think the freshness of it and the sweetness of the roasted tomatoes are going to complement the quite the salty, because it's almost like pepperami, the sausages. So you're just making a simple tomato sauce, mixing it up. I literally, a bit more black pepper, just to pop in there. Give that another whiz. And look at that colour, isn't that absolutely beautiful? Alrighty, so now we're just going to put that on the hob and let that just cook through now. Okay, so my pasta pot is come to a nice boil. So what I'm going to do is just add in the pasta. So how I like to think when the pasta's cooked, it literally just floats to the top. And then for roughly about 2 minutes, because fresh homemade pasta cooks so quickly, you would not believe it. And obviously we're doing a bit of a big batch here. So I haven't got a pastry thing, so I'm going to use like a salad thing that's got a bit of a spork on it. I'm going to spread that out. Okay, like that, like so. Move this out of the way. Again, it's not me farting. So now my chopped cooked sausages. I've been cooking off the tomato sauce and it's now come to a nice thick, I don't know, can you see that? A thick, rich texture. And that is lovely. So we're gonna add in the sausages into the tomato sauce. Now, using hands. Okay, so now our sauce, what we're going to do, use the other side of it. Going to mix it in to our sauce like that. So hopefully the saltiness of the red deer sausages is going to go lovely with the sweetness and the really deep, rich flavour of the roasted tomatoes. So I also added in some dried basil. Black pepper, no salt in this because obviously sausages have a lot of salt in it. I left the skin on the tomatoes because I just love the tomatoes in general. I don't like to separate it. Ooh, yeah, we got the skin of the. No, have we? What was that? No. Alrighty, so now we're just gonna let that sit in the heat. Perfect. And now I'm just gonna check on this pasta. You see what I mean? So as it's cooking, it's getting a bit more plumper. So it's doing good. Just make sure that it keeps getting separated. Yeah. All right. I'm going to put a lid on that now. Okay, so I've now drained off the pasta and, oh, hello. It is, I didn't roll it thin enough, unfortunately, so it is a bit thick, but you know what, it still tastes really, really good. There we go. So it is a bit thick, but yeah, like I said, it tastes really, really good. And the tomato sauce, simple basic tomato sauce with this red deer sausages in there, ready to be dished out.
Okay, so I am finally finished cooking, and there are the meals. So this is for dinner now. It looks a bit messy because I kind of just threw it in. Didn't mean to. So, and these are the lunches for myself and Anna for our cooking club. So I have a cooking channel, Cooking with Sasha China, which is my own channel. And then we have a channel called Two Far Easterns Cooking. Actually, I forgot the name. It's on Facebook. Two Far East Cookings with Sasha China and Anna. There we go. So it's my turn to cook dinner for tomorrow, or lunch tomorrow. So thanks for watching, guys. This was Cooking with Sasha China, and this was homemade pasta, tagliatelle style, with a homemade tomato basic sauce with red deer sausages. Alrighty, guys. Thanks for watching. Hopefully see you guys in the next one. It's a long video. Bye.